This is a transmitter for the Nano QX. Basically, you have two joysticks. The left one is for elevation as it goes up and down. And then also, if you go left or right, and you can see how that pops back to the center, that's going to spin your quadcopter either clockwise or counterclockwise. The right joystick, which always jumps back to the center, is for forward, backwards, left, and right. Whenever you turn on your quadcopter, the most important thing to do is have your throttle all the way down. That way you won't be spinning out of everywhere. Okay? When we turn it on, first thing you see is a red light, power on. This is already in high rate mode. Okay? That means when you go full left, it's going to really go full left. For beginners, you always want to start in low rate mode. That means if you go out like this a little bit, it'll do that much slower. It gives you a lot more smoother control over the quad. Okay, you see that there are 8 buttons here. Those are your trim buttons. Okay, so underneath the right one, you have left and right. Okay, as you press them, you hear a beep. I'm going to take this all the way down to the end. And that we hear those several rapid beats that you know you're all the way out the end. You'll probably never ever get to use that. We're going to go back up. And in a moment or two, you're going to hear a sustain sound. Okay, did you hear that? That is the neutral position. You should always start with all of your trims in neutral position. I'm just going to go ahead and check for forward and backward. There it is there. I can go down one, back up one. Okay, that's in neutral position. Throttle. That's good. And rotation. Okay, now they're all in the right position. My light is blinking, okay? That means I'm in low mode. This is where you really want to start on every time you start up the copter, okay? Unless you've just like switched out batteries. That means everything's in neutral, and your copter should fly basically pretty well, but it may need some trim. So just to give you an idea, let's say you start your copter up and it's going like that. It's going forward. You would back this down a beep or two. Try it again. Maybe it goes forward and you go one more and all of a sudden it's not moving forward anymore. It's just staying still. Usually you have to do a little trim of rotation down here, left or right or clockwise or counterclockwise. Some forward, backwards, and left and right. Let me just check this again. Okay. They're all in the right position. They're all neutral now. Most importantly, once again, for beginners, you want to make sure that's blinking. That'll allow you to fly much, much smoother. If you can do this in flight also, go to that. That's agility mode more. That's going to be your copter is going to react very, very quickly. Once again, always start with it blinking and power, the elevation power, all throttle all the way down.